Wait, hey, we are back. Yup, another new show, Mwana. This is the biggest show in UG. Don't say no, Mwana. There's no reason why this show. Yup, reliable. But apologies first. Let me start with apologies. I know people have been telling me I've been running repeats. I don't know what's wrong with me. I don't know if it's because I talk about pastors, but I just go home. I think I'm okay. I go to the hospital. Doctors tell me you're fine. Then I go back home. I'm so weak. I can't jack off. I can't eat. I can't do anything. But this time I went to hospital and the doctor told me yourself. So I'm okay. I even tested for HIV. I'm HIV negative. So if I, girls, if I approach you, we don't have to use a CD. Unless if you're sick, Moana, you have to tell me. Eh? What's happening today? Let me first read with your feedback. Caroline, Conanton, see, I like your show. I was trying to bang this car girl, Moana. By that time, I was still a Kapiri, Moana. Hey, me, yo, Conanton, see, I'm giving you cause I'm in your dreams. Hey, I'm on TV, I'm starting to have people like me. If you want me to hit it, now, you have to give me money for hair, saloon, transport. You have to take me out and I call my friend. And we eat your money. We eat all those things we don't know how to pronounce. Chocolate pizza, sivanyivichi. Can't you see the potential in a man? That's the problem with women. You get caught up in your world. To know that women, abachala bazibu, the mother of Ali Aliba, Yamuli Mbanti Muzungu, Ali Aliba is now 50 and he thinks he's white. You find him walking on Kampala Road and he sees white people and he's like, hi, hi race mates, hi I like mates. Can't you see? Oh, have you ever heard a Muzungu called Ali Aliba? Okay, so you can't hear the name. When you go back home, don't you have a mirror? OJ Razak, say to Msime, tell Museveni to go to Rwanda and teach his clansmen mulching instead of killing on power for more than 30 years here in UG. Mwana, what you passive? Emmanuel Gwasa says, bro, Owede, big man is fierce. This is response to that thing when I posted on social media. Museveni is mulching. Apparently, the guy was telling us that we should have 24 acres, all of us in Uganda, and we plant mushrooms. Maurice Opolo, Msime, nice observation. There is indeed no correlation between swimming and playing violin and agriculture. I've been watching your reliable noises without appreciating. Today, allow me to say big ups. Hey, I should be like 77 dogs, man. They should start putting the number of mobile money here. You make the show you send sometime. Magara Jimmy, go sing a kablaza. Hey, man, if you're a kablaza, I'm a big man. Tomanyira, man. I am the Hassan of Awasame. But why can't I have fans with normal names? When you have normal names, what happens to you? Adiatrice Kadi Oscar, WhatsApp group. We need a WhatsApp group. Man, I'm afraid. WhatsApp group kills your esteem. You start a WhatsApp group and everyone leaves. Left. Feel like no one likes you on earth. Engineer Pexon Derek, thanks for the show. I love it. Uma Sibs, today let me give you credit to Msime. Out of fun, you pass educative message. I hear swimming. How is it connected with paying bills 20 years after school? That has been your feedback. What is happening in Uganda, man? Stella Nyanzi. Who doesn't like that chick, Stella Nyanzi? Stella Nyanzi is so vulgar. Stella Nyanzi is more vulgar than 50 Cent, man. Like if 50 Cent came to Uganda to chill, tell Stella Nyanzi, bitch, you're vulgar, man. This chick doesn't have any... Mama. Did you see what she said to Jared Museveni on Facebook? I think Jared Museveni was like... Now, this is the thing about Stella Nyanzi. Personally, I just think that this chick is just blowing steam. Yes, I like her. She's a rhetorician. But what is she going to do? She has no end game. And you know that this Stella Nyanzi story doesn't end with a punchline. Because think about it. She cannot really overthrow anything. For you to have power and threaten a current regime, my friend, you don't do so by words. You do so by capturing power. That means capturing all the bodies of a country that make sure that power is secured. The police, that's law enforcement, the army, the judiciary, the electoral commission, and my friend, other sectors that control money so that you can be in charge. But Stella Nyanzi just comes and she has this language and she talks. She doesn't have... Stella Nyanzi is like... She's like how you see a woman with big hips and a big ass, but who's barren? Or she's like a man with a very big penis who can't make a woman pregnant, who shoots blanks. But for us who have pimples and we can make twins, so we are bad. So that's your Stella Nyanzi. And you know, your story, you don't have an end game. Yeah? All you can... Let me tell you, Stella Nyanzi is like Besigye. There's no difference. When Besigye came, he was also like that. Because when Besigye came, there was... Uganda had never seen anyone who was that charismatic as an opposition leader. Someone who was that bold, because people knew only people who would talk about Obote and Amina and disappear. But this guy seemed to be strong, move around Kampala. Then he came and people were like, Besigye, you're energetic, you're charismatic. Oh, we like you. He came back, Besigye, you're charismatic, you're strong, we like you. Then the third time people started saying, hey, Besigye, you're charismatic and you're energetic and they don't say we like you. Nowadays they say, Besigye, you're charismatic, you're energetic. Then we have started noticing his body flows, but you also have big eyes. That's why people are buying flat screen TVs to accommodate the size of his nose. That's the problem. So you know, that's the same story that Selanyans is going to go into. Selanyans, people like her right now, just because she's controversial, she has, no one has done what she has done before. To stand in front of TV and you talk about the balls of Besigye Mwana, the balls of Museveni, the things of Janeti Museveni. That's why people worship this chick. But you know, she has, I bet things that I can afford to lose. So I bet like toilet paper, majani. I don't bet money. But I bet you, Selanyanzi, she will disappear. Because that's the end. She doesn't have an... That's why the only thing that she has done that has worked is the party thing. Why? Because for party, she tried to build a structure. That's what Museveni did. When Museveni wanted to remove the government, he built a structure. He went to Tanzania, he got allies, and he came and he got guns, he got ammunition, and he took off the government. That's why the only thing Selanyanzi has done, it has become productive, is the pads. Because she built a structure. She put a mobile money number. That's how you build a structure. Nange, when I have like 3,000, that's what Chaga tried to do with Chameleon. Chaga spent 10 years saying that he's the one who made Chameleon. And he realized that Chameleon will always be a star and he will always be upcoming. Now he's upwent. He chilled. You know, that's the same thing that happened to Bobby Wine. Hey, I'm the one who made that cowboy. He's a poor man. Now the man is stuck to smoking weed and he's there. He went back to school. You know, that's it. You know, that's what happened to Mega D. Mega D was here telling us, I had the one who started the dance hall. First of all, that's fake patois. How can you not know patois and you started dance hall in Uganda? He also relaxed and he went back. He went to Buche, yo, my friend. You look at a person like Akena. Akena thought that you could just run UPC like he was running his ghetto when he was smoking weed. This guy, this weed abuser, went and talked to Google and they first deleted all his pictures. When you try to see Akena smoking weed, nothing shows up. And he went to UPC. He went to UPC to try to mobilize support. What happened at the end of the day? He had to put his tail back and decide an agreement with NRM. Now he's part of the big man's league. There's nothing you can do. At the end of the day, if you're just shouting and you don't... The way you can really put up a government and you put a threat to it, maybe through vocals, you get statistics. Find out all the countries that have the same GDP as Uganda, power purchasing parity, and compare the statistics and tell us what Museveni could have done and he has not yet done. But you coming and keeping us telling us that Museveni doesn't shave. We also don't shave, my friend. You know, we are in the same boat. But this business, and another thing, who are you trying to incite by using dirty words? Let me tell you, the only people that you have ever mobilized who are sensible are the people for the pads when you had a cause. Then this business of talking about gang bangers, you are appealing to porn addicts, Jack Pemba. One hand is on the phone, another hand is busy down doing some heavy duty Timothy Code. Those are people that you are appealing to, just a gang of masturbators. Man, you know, before you talk about a guy, first see the reputation of the person you're saying he doesn't have the penis and he sent his wife. This dude has people showing up out of, he has his legacy. He just busy in the state house ordering and people are just busy showing up, 50-year-old people saying that this is my father. This dude Kwegamba, he was just distributing seed all over Uganda. This is the man you say he doesn't have the balls. My friend, just first have your facts straight. He has both the wife of the opposition leader and the current wife. How can you? My friend, if you don't have facts, shut up. Moria Ebonos is coming up, but as for now, Mwana, I need to first blow off some steam. Where is that lotion? Let's first go, Jacob. You can join me. We can all come back after the break when we are all fresh. Don't go anywhere.